pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Excuse me.
Been needling lately?
Okay, this evening's agenda, we have, first of all, to announce that next Tuesday is voting day, March 13th. Polls will be open at 7 a.m. until 7 p.m. at the Scenic Regional High School. So please get out to vote. We're going to have a non-public session at 6:30 for interviews for the Emergency Management Director's position. The other thing we're going to discuss is we did receive correspondence from Town Council that the State Attorney General's office now has someone handling the issue of the Smithville Cemetery and the encroachment into the state's right-of-way. So hopefully we'll be able to come to terms with that and get something in the town's favor with some options that were suggested to them. Did you forward him that letter that he had asked for? So he's got that. So was he going to set up?
Yes, but you have to give me the dates.
When are you guys available? Remember, we're dealing with the state.
Mm-hmm.
Dates and times.
So I'm guessing they're going to want hours during the day, correct? Is that why you mentioned we're dealing with the state? They're not going to want to come down on a Tuesday evening when we're having a selectmen's meeting. Is that what you're alluding to?
We can give them that as an option.
We
ask for dates and times, the plural.
Yeah, so I mean, let's try at least one Tuesday. Right? That can't hurt. Available most Saturdays.
Most days after 2:30, I can make stuff happen.
If I have to, I can do that. I'm not out of work till 4:30, but if I need to, I can make arrangements.
So that time will be out.
Okay, so when are you going?
I leave on the 17th. I'll be back on the 29th. So since next week is voting, I really doubt that Tuesday's gonna come into play.
But if I could do it on one of the other days.
Yeah. I know. Far enough in advance, I think.
Is there any days that are not flip? You know, days of week?
If I was to pick one that does not work for me, it'd be Wednesday.
Yeah, let's see what she's available.
6-7 a.m. is good before work.
I'm busy.
I'm already so
you're,
busy.
Yeah, you're probably already at work.
Yeah, I'm already at work.
I wish I was already at work.
Well, you did take next Tuesday off, right?
No, I didn't.
You put in your PTO or whatever you call it over there?
Yeah. I did not take next Tuesday off.
Okay.
We just need to call Dougie directly.
That's, I did. He said he's got plenty to take off.
I do. I do. I have ample amount of time. I will be over there probably somewhere around 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Stay out of it.
Yeah. Is there so many feet around the box?
You just don't want any.
Right.
What, me taking somebody's ballot, changing it, and putting it in the machine?
Right, exactly.
I don't know.
You know how it is in the swamp, you know.
Yeah.
Which button? There's a button there?
I'm just.
Yeah. There's something in there that I do remember reading it.
I think Bob's going to write off or print off what the selectmen's duties actually are.
You got that book there, yeah? Or do I
yeah,
go
yeah you went and tested the machine today.
Yeah.
The one for the...
Are we able to fill the day?
Guidelines and whatnot. Do you have that?
For
voting. Yeah.
I don't know.
Oh, the spiral mind.
Yeah, I think it's on the...
Okay, I'll grab that. I'll take a quick peek. I want to make sure I don't...
Are we able to fill the day with a selectman? Between you two, are you guys going to be able to handle
it? I already delegated her as my
representative. That's where I was going. We got to.
I'm in the building.
You're in the building? Is that?
I'll be nowhere near the ballot box. But I will be in the building starting at 6 a.m. in the morning.
All right, so you'll be there for the morning show.
Yeah.
Good.
I'm in the building from 6, and then I can go home after that because I've been there from 6 to 2.
True.
6 to 3.
I don't think there was a limit on time.
Yeah.
I'll be in the building if they need me. They can come. Yeah.
What's that,
George?
Okay. Meeting minutes. We can. Is this your copy or can I put it back?
Motion to accept the meetings of the public and non-public February 27th, 2018.
There's second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any further discussion regarding the light tech proposal?
Like I said, I'd like some information on whether it does or does not include the buildings that we don't want to spend any money on.
Okay, could you, I believe this was started by Peter. I think now this should be assigned to Mark.
Yeah.
Question number one is whether this included the modules at the fire station.
Yeah, because based, yeah.
Yeah.
In my reading it looks like it does, and I don't want to spend any money on that.
All right. Question two, from my perspective, was are the rebate programs still in play? Three, what fixtures would they be proposing to provide for that cost? Do you have anything on that, Jay?
No, I read through it. I think it's a good idea. It's something we certainly should be looking into. But I would agree with John. I don't think we need to be putting any kind of lighting in the modules or I mean, like this second building, I don't know if that was part of the plan or, and then the best fit, I would be, what is the best light for us?
Well, one of the things the fourth question I'd like to say is if they have looked at the park.
Sure.
And the exterior of all of these buildings.
Good question.
Because I think that's where a lot of our lighting goes, cost wise.
Joanne, maybe can answer this. I just was looking at something. What is the stipend? The year. Okay.
This is a renewal for the Turnpike Auto.
Well, it's a different form that the state informed them they have to complete and submit to them. But we had already granted their junkyard permit.
Do you know if either of the chiefs are going to join us?
They both are.
And Jim as well? I believe you're right. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I remember that conversation though.
Yeah, are you thinking?
Oh, yeah. I think we had the discussion, said no.
Yeah. Oh, okay, very good. Thank you for reminding me.
Yes, we did have that here. You did have
that. We did.
Yeah.
That's why there's three of us. Somebody's gonna remember half of it.
Oh, we look to the young guy.
Yeah, I liked when he said, at least we know, remember half of it. He goes, that's why they looked at me. I'm like, so I only know half of it, so I know all that. Yeah.
Well, he and I are a quarter.
Okay.
Can't get in trouble if you only know half of it.
Exactly.
On your agendas?
No.
Jay?
Well, we're talking about how we could enhance or draw people into the town, different things, you know. And I had the pleasure of going to and maybe this is just me being old, John, but I don't know. Not so much a bluegrass, but a string. They called it Appalachian Mountain Music, and I thought it was kind of neat. So I would almost wonder if the rec department wouldn't entertain looking into something like that. You know, that could be a draw if we could get some talent.
Since we're talking that subject now, one of the things that I had asked them if they could entertain, and I told them John would head it up. I remember reading this town. I don't remember where it was, but I said, boy, that was a good idea. They shut down Main Street, tables right down the middle. They had a dinner during the summer. You know, you buy tickets to it, sit down, and it was more, I wouldn't say formal, but it was a nice dinner.
Yeah.
And on that one there, they were trying to involve, like, the local farmers, the local chefs, you know, a lot of the local people to participate in it. And I thought, boy, that would be a good community gathering event. You know, we probably can't shut down Turnpike Road, but maybe Main Street.
Well, even the Academy King Road portion to the Common.
Yeah.
You could, you know, that kind of thing.
Yeah. Then one of the other things that I've been noticing, and I, as long as we're talking about it now, I look at the town property where I'm seeing a lot of signs just getting put up. And to me, personally, that's distracting. You know, people put up signs, wood for sale.
Oh, yeah.
And it's just...
It's always been a bone of contention, I guess, for me, for that purpose. You'll see a yard sale sign put up Saturday, a yard sale. And 3 weeks later, the sign's still there.
Still there, yeah.
It's like, you know, put it up, but make sure you take it down kind of thing. Yeah, that's the...
Well, I think it's just anything, you know. So if you come down Turnpike, okay, there was a while back, you know, they went through and they took down all those trees, right? Okay, and there was a big thing because I guess some people went in and were taking the wood off of what I'm assuming what they assumed to be, you know, the right of way or whatever, clearing it out. And then there was a big deal of, well, that's our land, or that's our wood, or whatever. We had a non-post or a posted sign. But I drove past this morning, and there's still just a lot of dead trees and wood still laying in that same property. And it's one of those things, I'm like, you know, I get it's winter and everything like that, but it's one of those things, as you're coming into town, that's something that you're seeing, and someone was clearing it, you didn't want it cleared, but it's still sitting there.
See, and I know exactly what you're talking about, and I agree 100%, and I didn't know if that was something that they cleared and just left it there, and the owner really wouldn't have cared whether they took it or not, or whether the owner did want it. But I would have thought it was just a letter to Eversource to say, hey, you did this, how about picking up? But you raise a good point. If it is the landowner that wanted it, then that would be...
Right. And I think that was it. And I know when Eversource, they were supposed to do it on some of my property, and you had the choice of they would take it or they'll leave it for you. Mm-hmm. And but yeah, I mean, these I saw a couple times there were people there loading it, and then on social media where there was a big uproar of, well, does anyone know who it was, and can you help us contact them because we had plans for the wood and this. And but like I said, I drive past today, and it's not just little stuff, it's not just brush. I mean, there's some decent sized logs laying just scattered, and it's just it looks like we just had the ice storm again in parts of that. It's just a and because I look at it as that's like you said, you drive into town, you see Welcome to Ipswich, and then a quarter mile down the road, it looks like, you know.
Maybe we can contact the landowner and see if they're going to, or if they want us to ask Eversource to.
Yeah.
I think the option of Eversource doing now is probably gone if they told Eversource they wanted it.
Yeah. But it's all, if they're not going to clear it, then maybe they could put up a sign, you know, free, take, because people... I mean, you see it all the time. People are pulling up with trailers and clearing that wood.
Do they want it? I've always thought once the wood's been sitting on the ground, it's not good for firewood.
For a period of time, it'd be fine.
Yeah.
Yeah, a couple of years, it should be fine.
Yeah.
So, depending on what it is, if it's oak, you can leave it there for 5, but ash is probably junk in a couple of years.
Yeah, and birch is like 3 months.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, if we could contact the landowner and just ask, you know, do they have plans to clear it this spring/summer? If not, you know.
It's up to them completely.
Yeah, exactly.
If they say, no, we're not cutting it until 2020, and nobody can have it, then we live with it.
Right.
Yeah.
But I think it's just, even just drawing attention that, you know, it's noticed.
Sure. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm fine with that.
Good evening.
Chief.
Good evening.
We make a motion to close the meeting and go into non-public.
You're making it, or you want to?
I need somebody.
Is 91.3C.
Is that the one in?
I think it's 91.3C.
It has been discussed in public. Matters which discussed in public would likely affect adversely the reputation of any person other than members of the public body itself.
I'll second.